Last video, we discussed the instruction set of 8085 microprocessor. In this video, we will be discussing about stack and subroutines. Let us see the first topic, stack, briefly. The stack is a group of memory locations in the read or write memory. It is used for temporary storage of data during the execution of a program. Stack handles data in an organized manner. There are last in first out memory, that is LIFO. Okay, so we can add items to the top or remove them from the top. Adding an item to the stack is called push operation, and removing from the stack is called pop operation. So using push and pop instructions, the information is stored or retrieved from the stack. Already, you know the function of push and pop instructions. See the slide. Push instruction, push register pair onto stack. In here, opcode is push, operand register pair. The register pair may be either PC register pair, DE register pair, HL register pair, PSW. Okay, processor status word or program status word. So, PSW is nothing but is a 16-bit register. It contains accumulator register and flag register. So, accumulator register acts as high order register. Flag register acts as low order register. So, push operand as register pair. So, the operand may be either DC register pair, DE register pair, HL register pair or PSW register. Okay, so, it is a single byte instruction. It needs 3 machine cycles and 12 T states. Function of push instruction is the content of the register pair is designated in the operand or copied into the stack in the following sequence. The stack pointer register is decremented and the content of the high order register, that is B, D, H and accumulator, are copied into the location. Okay, then the stack pointer register is decremented again and the content of the low order register, that is C, E, L and flag register content, are copied into that location. So, here no flags are affected. See the example, assume stack pointer register contains 2099, the register B contains 32 and C register contains 57. Save the content of the BC register pair on the stack. So, here instruction is push B. Okay, so BC register pair is used. So, for push B, the hex code is C5. So, from the opcode chip, we can write the opcode value for push B register. Okay, so before execution of push B, the register content is, that is BC register content is 3257. Stack pointer content is 2099. So, after execution of push B, the stack content, that is 2099, we don't know the value. So, initially, the stack pointer holds that address value. Also, once the push B instruction is executed, first it is decremented by 1. So, that time, the high order register, that is B content is nothing but 32, is stored in 2098. Once again, it is decremented by 1, that is 2097. Okay, the low order register content 57 is stored in 2097 location. So, this is the function of push instruction. So, after execution, the register content the same, that is B32, C register contains 57. So, the stack pointer content is 2097. So, before execution, the stack pointer is 2099. After execution, the stack pointer holds the address, that is 2097. So, this is the push B register function. The next one is pop off stack to register pair. So, here opcode is pop register pair is nothing but BC register pair, DE register pair, HL register pair, or PSW. So it is a single byte instruction, 3 machine cycles, number of key states 10. So here example, assume the stack pointer register contains 2090, data byte F5 is stored in memory location 2090 and data byte 01 is stored in location 2091. Transfer the content of the stack to register pair H and L. So this is the function of pop H. So here hex code is E1. So this is copied from opcode shape. So before execution of pop H, the HL register, we don't know the value. Stack pointer content is 2090. So after execution, the stack pointer content, that is 2090, contains F5, 2091 contains 01. Okay, after execution of pop H instruction, 2090 is nothing but F5, 2091 is nothing but 01. So the HL register value is nothing but 01 and F5. 01 is the high order register data, then F5 is the low order register data. So SP is nothing but 2092 after execution of pop H register. So this is about function of push and pop instruction. So these two instructions are used in case of stack. The next one is difference between push and pop instruction. Push instruction stores the register content in the stack, whereas pop instruction gets the register content from the stack. In case of push instruction, the stack pointer register is decremented by 2, whereas pop instruction, the stack pointer register content is incremented by 2. Here push instruction example, push RP register. RP is nothing but register pair. In case of pop instruction, here examples are pop RP. Okay, then push instruction is used to store register data temporarily in stack memory, whereas pop instruction is used to retrieve the data from the stack. So the stack pointer is a 16-bit register which holds the address of the top of the stack. The stack is generally initialized at the highest available memory location. Once the stack location is defined, data can be stored in stack from memory address, that is 1 less than the address of the stack pointer. The stack is shared both by the programmer and the microprocessor. The programmer can store the content of a register pair in a stack. Similarly, the microprocessor automatically stores the content of the program counter when a subroutine is called. Okay, so the LIFO, that is the last in first row, nature of the stack is primarily used to store the return address when a subroutine is called. So this is about stack. The next topic is subroutine. The basic idea of subroutine is large programs are hard to handle, so they can be broken into small programs. They are called subroutines. Okay, so subroutines are used in main program. So here, writing subroutines, that is, when should we jump? Using call instruction. Where do we return to? Using return instruction. So here subroutine instruction needs 2 instructions. One is call instruction, another one return instruction. Okay, so here subroutine is a group of instructions written separately from the main program to perform a function that occurs repeatedly in the main program. For example, multiplication of scalars, time delay, inversion of matrix, etc. So these are the examples of subroutines. Okay, may be required at many places in the program. The instruction required to perform these tasks have to be written at all the places where the task occur. This would waste memory space. In order to use the memory space, is efficiently, the above instructions are written once as a separate unit called subroutine. Whenever needed, the control is diverted to the subroutine. On execution of the call instruction, the subroutine execution will begin. At the end of the subroutine, there will be a return instruction. Following the execution of return instruction, the control is transferred to the main program. Then the execution of the main program will resume from the instruction immediately after the call instruction. So, the next slide for subroutine, see, this is main program. So, in main program, call instruction is used for to call the subroutine program. So, using call instruction, the control is transferred to the subroutine. Okay? In main program, we are using two times call instruction. During first call operation, the control, the processor control is transferred to the subroutine. After completing subroutine program, using return instruction, again the control is transferred to the main program. Similarly, see the second call subroutine. So, once call subroutine instruction is executed, that time the processor control is transferred to the subroutine. After completing subroutine program, the using return instruction, again it comes to the main program. The control comes to the main program. This is the subroutine diagram. So, in subroutine, call and the return instructions are used. So, already you know there are two types of call instructions. One is unconditional call, another one conditional call. So, this is unconditional subroutine call instruction. So, here opcode is call, operand 16-bit address is specified. Okay, so this is 3-byte instruction, 5 machine cycles needed, 18 T states needed for this. The hex code for call is CD. Okay, so here example, we call instruction at memory location 2010 to call a subroutine located at 2050. So explain the sequence of events when the stack pointer is at location 2099. See, the program 2010 contains CD. CD is nothing but call opcode. Then 2011 contains 50. That is 16-bit address. 50 is nothing but low order 8-bit address. Then 2012 indicates 20. That this is high order 8-bit address, call address. So, execution of call instruction, that is in the program counter 2013, is placed on the stack. Okay, first the stack pointer is decremented to 2098, then MSB is stored, then stack pointer is again decremented, LSB is stored, then call address, that is 2050, is temporarily stored in internal WZ registers and placed on the bus for the fetch cycle. Okay, so this is the function of call instruction. So this is return instruction written from subroutine unconditionally. Here opcode is return, that is RET, operand, there is no operand field. It is a single byte instruction. Number of machine cycles 3, number of T states 10. The hex code is C9. The function of return instruction is the program sequence is transferred from the subroutine to the calling program. The 2 bytes from the top of the stack are copied into the program counter and the program execution begins at the new address. The instruction is equivalent to pop program counter. Okay, here no flags are affected. Here assume the stack pointer is pointing to location 2095. Explain the effect of RET instruction if the content of the stack locations are as follows. Okay, 2095 contains 50, 2096 contains 20. After instruction RET, the program execution is transferred to location 2050 and the stack pointer is shifted to location 2097. The instruction is used in conjunction with call or conditional call instructions. So these are the difference between call and return instructions. Call instruction is used to redirect program execution to the subroutine, whereas a return instruction is used to return to the main program at the end of the subroutine program. Then call subroutine is conditionally located at the memory address specified by the 16 bit operand, whereas return instruction is unconditionally from the subroutine. Okay, then call instruction takes place the address of the next instruction on the stack and transfer the program execution to the subroutine address. Whereas return instruction locates the return address on the top of the stack and transfer the program execution back to the calling program. Call instruction must be used in combining with a return instruction in the subroutine. For example, call 4500, whereas the call instruction should be used in the main program accompanied by the return instruction in the subroutine. For example, RET. These are the difference between call and return instructions.